Good morning students, welcome to your online videos of science class. We are discussing the revision, the chapter, first chapter of your science that is food and health, and we are at the end of the chapter and we will only discuss that why exercise and rest and good posture is important for our health. Besides eating a balanced diet and remaining clean, you also need to exercise regularly. So exercise on your body, to keep your body fit, you must exercise. You have to keep yourself clean and you have to eat a balanced diet. Along with that, you have to be very much fit from within, and that is why regular exercise is needed. Exercise also makes your inner organs such as the heart and the lungs stronger. So the main functioning part of your body is your brain, and brain is connected with different parts of our body. And to stay healthy, not only functioning of brain is important, but heart and health is also equally important. Lack of exercise make your muscles weak and flabby. So it can make you healthy. If you do not exercise properly, it can make you flabby and healthy. And that can accumulate your body and make you overweight and unhealthy. So if a child, or even right from the beginning up to end of your life, if a person will be unnecessarily healthy, and if the person will be overweight, then he would be unable to do his regular work. It is obvious, isn't it? Day-to-day life will be spoiled. Your body needs rest to recover and carry out repairs. Now, when you are unhealthy, you need rest, isn't it? Only working will also not help. You have to take adequate rest. You should get at least 8 hours of sleep every night so that you can wake up fresh and ready for the next day. See, we are abided by all the work of our day-to-day life. We have to work, we need more and more energy. So if only working will not help, you need rest. So every day you have to take rest at least 8 hours, I'm sorry. And sleep every night properly so that the next morning you feel healthy and fresh. Exercise and rest help the body to be healthy. Next is posture. In addition to exercise, the rest, good posture is also important. Now see, good posture means the way you are either standing or walking or sitting. The good posture is very important. Posture is the position of your body. So what is the actual position of your body? Always sit, stand and walk straight. So if I hunch like this, if I bend myself like this, afterwards I will feel pain in my back, isn't it? If I twist my body and sit in an improper way, that can bring pain in my different muscles, isn't it? So the posture is very, very important. This is good for your bones and muscles. So when you are sitting straight, walking straight, or sitting, bending, propping, whatever posture you are taking, when you are taking it in a straight way, then it is very good for your health. Slouching means sitting, standing, or walking with the body bent or hunched is the bad habit. It's bad for body. So it is when you twist your body, afterwards you see that you cannot move your leg or you cannot move your hand. Unconsciously, when you sleep something and you press your hand, or maybe your posture is incorrect, after getting up from the bed you will see your leg is not working properly or your hand is not working properly for some time. After you jerk it, after you move it, it will come back to its original place. So this is all about the chapters. I think all of the exercises you have done. In the class also, when I have done the chapter, I have done everything. So I think I don't need to repeat. Just once I will tell you some important question of the chapter so that I can finish it completely. Okay, the nutrients definition, and what are the different types of nutrients, what are the other name of nutrients, what are the sources of nutrients, moreover what are the disease which can occur due to the less eating, and what are the sources of these nutrients. Balanced diet, Then preservation of foods, how to preserve the food, different types of disease we have read, difference between infectious and non-infectious disease it can come, and how to prevent from ourselves from infectious disease, what are the sources of infection through which infection can spread, what are the way, okay. And finally, deficiency disease, as I have told you in the previous video, you have to read the different sources of vitamins and minerals, and from deficiency of that, what type of disease is occurring, it is important for your objective. And finally, good posture, why it is important, that also question can come. So, mainly two long questions, that is different types of nutrients, difference between infectious and non-infectious disease, and what are the different way of preservation of food, and finally, what are the way of prevention of infectious disease. This type of question can come from the chapter. Go through it thoroughly, go through the spellings thoroughly, so that during writing you get no problem in the spellings, because behind each spellings we are supposed to cut half marks of the question. So be very careful. Thank you.